Well, I'm delighted to say I'm joined by the whole Tottenham Hotspur coaching staff. Guys, how are you?
Very well.
I knew they'd do that. Something tells me this is going to be a very interesting interview. Mauricio, serious note, Champions League final, the sun is shining, we're in Madrid. How proud will you be walking out Tottenham Hotspur Football Club in a Champions League final?
No, we are so excited. I think you can feel here in Madrid. I think it's an amazing moment. It's a period that always we are going to remember, always in our mind, in our heart. And of course, enjoying a lot and hoping to finish in a very good way Saturday.
Jesus, give me an insight into the last few weeks, the preparation, how much goes into preparing the team and everything, the travel that goes into a big game.
I think it's been amazing almost 3 weeks since the last game of the Premier League. And it was a real starting point for the team, you know, because the league and all the competitions were left behind. We all are very pleased the way the players approach every day. So it's been amazing.
Let's look back at some of the moments, because there's been some incredible moments for Tottenham in the Champions League. Miggy, after the Man City game, I want to talk about the hug that you all had, the coaching staff. You see the passion, so much emotion that came through with the coaching staff. That was a really big moment for the football club, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a big moment. Big moment because everything happening in this game was a little bit crazy from the beginning. And the emotion were up and down during the whole game. And to arrive at the end of the game with the win into the qualification was a big moment for us, for the staff, for the team, and for the whole club. I think it was a big moment. When they scored, we feel like everything was dead. And a few seconds after change, and the emotion was enormous, was big.
And we didn't think, Sebastian, as a Spurs fan, as Spurs representatives, that the emotion could get more so than the Man City game. But then the Ajax game, the emotion was incredible with what happened and how late Spurs got that winning goal. Incredible.
It's incredible, and I think that once you see the Man City game, you believe that anything can happen.
Yeah.
So in one way, you're still surprised, it's football, but then something inside your body, while you were watching the game, told you that something magic can happen. So when it actually arrives there, you don't know how you're going to react, but I think the emotion just takes you over.
So you always believed because of what happened in the Man City
game? Yeah, I don't think you never stop believing, you know?
Another big moment in this campaign, Hugo Lloris's penalty save. Big, big moment from Sergio Aguero, that penalty save. Someone that you know very well, you work very closely with. How happy were you for him with that moment?
In this moment, the situation was very bad. Very bad for us, penalty against us, play at home. And I think from their moment changed the situation, the game. And I think Hugo, his feeling was amazing. All stadium, no? And from our position, of our side, very happy for him because he's a very, very good man.
Guys, we've got some memorable clips here from Tottenham's Champions League campaign. I don't know if you've seen all of these, so we're going to play them to you and get your reaction of these moments. So, Mauricio, this is in Ajax, of course. And just explain what you're doing here. This is you're showing your appreciation to the Spurs fans that travelled.
Yes, of course. They were amazing. They are amazing. I've seen if you talk about something special from this club is the fans, our fans.
Jesus, I can see you smiling just watching that. In terms of the amount of games that you've been involved in with Tottenham, was that one of the best atmospheres you've ever experienced from Tottenham fans?
Yeah, I think it's well, the meaning of the game and the result, you know. But I think that clip, he shows the connection of him with the club, represented by the fans. His leadership, because in a moment he turned to say, you know, to show his appreciation to us. So that's why he's the kind of leader he is, you know. He never shows he's the number one above of everyone, but he wants to feel, you know, us to feel a big part of the journey.
Got to talk about your relationship, because you're very happy, very close. So what do you all do outside of football? Do you meet up? What do you do outside of football when football stops? Do you socialise, Maurizio? You go, you have dinner together?
Yes, sometimes. We don't have too much time to socialise because we spend from 7:30 to until 8:07, depend. And of course, you need to spend some time, family time, and it's, we go home, and then, oh, we have a dinner together, or maybe we go to some restaurant. It's like, yeah, it's a little bit too much, you know, for...
too much time together.
Too much time. Only we miss to sleep together, maybe. But, you know, I think we spend a lot of time together. The good thing, I think we enjoy every day. Yes, that is always is like a new motivation. Every day some, you know, always we find a way to inspire each other, to motivate each other, to feel the necessity to be together, you know. That is so important. You know, when you start to work all together, it's like it's a massive question mark. You say, oh, maybe in 1 year or in 2 years or in maybe three, but some problem can happen and, you know, some problem can to start. But I think we are working nearly 8-9 years together. And it's like, it's our first day, you know, working.
And you mentioned that you eat together, you spend a lot of time together working. So if you were going to all meet up, Jesus, and you wanted to meet up for a dinner, who is the best cook out of everyone here? To cook a dinner?
Difficult, huh?
I put the plates and...
Yeah. We have to do asado.
If I pick...
Yeah.
Sebas.
Yes. What is your signature dish?
God, I'm lucky to have a mother that taught me quite a lot of tricks. But then when there's a big day for a barbecue, yeah, and the big responsibility is there, I think it's for the gaffer,
oh, for
to
the
show
gaffer
his skills.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, Mickey. Is good. It's good, yeah, because you only do the barbecue, if yeah, not, play guitar.
You play guitar, Mickey.
And sing.
Can you demonstrate a song for us now?
No.
That is good weather. It's a good weather.
It is good. It's sand.
And I heard that there was an incident with your car, Miggy, at the car door. Can you explain what happened with the car door?
I know. If you explain. You explain, and then if you are, no, you cheat.
No, it's good to remain if pay the invoice. the bill, no, because
yes,
I broke
Maurizio's car door.
Yes,
how
yes,
did
yes
you do that?
Was windy, so windy in
Rosario. It's very windy.
Yes,
oh,
very windy.
I said, Mickey,
be careful.
It's very windy.
No. Before it happened.
Open the door.
Open the door and it broke.
And yes,
okay. Remember no pay.
Like
remember, didn't pay.
Like the door here on the reception, that the
the revolving door.
Yeah. It's like this after.
So what you paid for it to be fixed?
I paid for
to be fixed.
Yes.
Of course.
If not, the car seems a Flintstone.
Was the only car? Was the only car with only one door in Rosario?
One door. On that note, I think that is the perfect note to end it, guys. Mm. Absolute pleasure. Thank you very much. Wish you all the best for Saturday night. And of course, as all our guests have done, they're going to sign this shirt, signed by all of our guests. It's a great prize for one very lucky viewer. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good. Thank you.